Hello guys, Curious Ladka here, and today I'm going to give you an overview and a review of this TP-Link Archer C50 wireless router. So let's get started. As you can see, there are some specs mentioned on the box, like it has 4 antennas, it's a dual band router as you can see here. It supports 2.4 GHz as well as 5 GHz of Wi-Fi bands, and these are some more of specs that the 2.4 GHz band supports up to 300 Mbps of transfer speeds, and the 5 GHz band supports up to 867 Mbps of Wi-Fi speeds. And there are some more specs mentioned on the box, but I'll give you some B-rolls and so you can see them in detail. So now let's open the box. Now I have my trusty knife with me, some sort of an overkill for this product unboxing. And now we have the router itself. Some quick installation guide. And some public licensing and all sort of crap. An RJ45 Ethernet cable. And the power cord. Let's see what it is rated at. It's rated at 9 volts and 0.85 amperes, so about 6 to 7 watts of power consumption. So let's get started with the overview. As this is a quad antenna router, two of the antennas are reserved for the 2.4 GHz band and the rest two are reserved for the 5 GHz band. On the front, we have some status LEDs, the power indication, the 2.4 and 5 GHz band LEDs, Wi-Fi LEDs. This is the line-in. If you plug in the internet service provider Ethernet cable that is coming to your home, this LED lights up. This is the LED that lights up when the router is able to connect to the internet. And this is a WPS indication light. On the back, we have the ports, the DC input, power on-off, the router reset switch, the WPS switch. This blue jack is used to input the ISP internet Ethernet cable, so as to provide the router with the internet access. And these four ports are output ports, and you can use them to connect the computer with an Ethernet cable. So now the moment that you all have been waiting for, the feeling. So now let's set this router. There are two ways to set this router. One is via the web interface and the second is via the mobile app. The app is called TP-Link Tether, and one of the features of the Archer C50 is that it is compatible with this app. So you will have to download it and open it. You can see that I have already done that. I'll just swipe through this and let's get started. I'll agree to this privacy in terms of use, as you'll have to do as well. I'll show you how to set this up, the full process, because I've already done it in my case. So I'll just tap this icon. And I have a router. Now first, make sure that you are connected to the Wi-Fi that you are just trying to set the router. So I'll turn it on. And this is the Archer C50, the E47A. I'll just connect to it. The password is given on the back of the router itself, so no need to worry about that. I'll just tap that this is a wireless router. I've already connected the hardware, which is the ISP internet cable that is provided to me and the power adapter. And next, 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 and we are done. The Wi-Fi LEDs are solid on. And as you can see that I am already connected to the Wi-Fi,
I'll just tap I'm connected, and it will just look for the devices for about a few seconds. And this is the Archer C50. I'll just tap. The username and password by default are admin and admin, and it is given in the quick installation guide as well. Login. In my case, I have to do a few of settings more. I'll go to tools, then the internet connection, and I'll have to choose triple PoE, and it may differ in your case, so you'll have to choose accordingly. I'll just tap on triple PoE, enter my username and password as I've already done it, and tap on save. And thus, in a few seconds, it should show that it is connected. And now, as you can see, my Wi-Fi is connected and my access point is now working. After testing the Archer C50 for 3 days, here's my verdict. The strength of the signal is not exceptional or something to write home about. It's the same as my old TP-Link W8968 router, which is about 6 years old and has 2 antenna only. But the signal quality is much better, that's for sure. The pages load faster and I can use Wi-Fi in faraway rooms in my home with no problem, which I couldn't before. The 5 GHz band has its obvious drawbacks of low range, but it's not the fault of the router. Overall, in about 1700 Indian national rupees or about $25, it's a great router to buy. That's it for now. Ask your questions in the comments and subscribe or like this video. Thank you for watching.